on this edition of Ultrasound.
Do you remember a guy named Alan Hunter?
We'll hear from MTV's five original VJs.
My time at MTV, I was at the center of the universe.
Mark Goodman backstage at Live Aid.
It's kind of the original Real World.
To find out what it was like in the early era of music video.
I want my MTV!
24 hours a day on cable TV.
We'll catch up with what they're doing now.
It's a good way to let out a lot of stress.
And reminisce with the first people who could say,
believe it or not, I was an MTV VJ.
MTV has seen more than its share of intriguing personalities come through its doors over the years.
Then Weasel.
Each of them bringing their own special brand of small screen charisma to the airwaves. But all these talented people owe a debt to the original VJs, the groundbreakers, the fearless pioneers who throughout the channel's infancy and adolescence were the human face of MTV. But back in 1981, they were just five music-loving men and women with fresh faces and fresh outlooks.
I remember making a pitch at Eyewitness News, they cover rock and roll.
Are you excited about tonight, about Los Angeles and playing in touring
yes,
America
it's
again?
Yes, it's sort of a bit like coming back and eating something Mother used to bake.
Now, I knew if I did it weekly, this would make me a star in Los Angeles.
That was what I wanted to do. I wanted to get into television doing music.
I was in a David Bowie video, Fashion. And that gave me my first taste of what a music video was.
I was reading one morning, reading Billboard, and I saw this article about MTV and looking for video jockeys, hosts.
And they asked me if I'd audition.
I figured that they had the black guy, they had the Jew, they had the dumb blonde gal, and they needed the airhead, you know, blonde Midwestern guy. And I went down to the studio and did the world's worst audition. I mean, it was terrible. And if you have my audition tape, I'm going to kill you.
Alan Hunter, audition, ad-lib, take one.
Michael McDonald, the head of the group, sends the group into melodious song. Can we start over again? Blank. It goes nowhere. They're evil. These are evil people. Thank you very much.
I went back twice more, I guess. And then 2 days later, they called and said, you're hired. And I said, hired for what? When the hell is this show? 24 hours a day of video?
When I first, you know, got what it was, I was like, oh, right, okay, right. 24-hour radio, but on television. It makes perfect. God, that makes sense. God, that's a good idea. God, why didn't I think of that?
It's exactly what I wanted to do. That's what I wanted to do in Los Angeles, basically, was making it in a small kind of local way, make that leap. Now, here they were going to do it nationally, possibly internationally. You know, so I loved the vision that they had. It was extremely exciting.
Then there was Meg Griffin, one of New York's most respected DJs. MTV had selected her to be an original VJ, but she never made it onto the air.
She quit. And Martha should be very happy that she quit, because Meg was the Martha Quinn type.
I was an intern at WNBC. What that really meant was I was in the back closet alphabetizing hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of singles.
Martha was in college 5 minutes before MTV started, you know?
JJ came from KLOS, Mark went from WPLJ, and I was dispensing toilet paper at Weinstein Dormitory at NYU.
I went to New York. And for that month, as soon as I got there, basically, we were rehearsing.
It seemed like forever from the time that I got the job until we were on the air. It never seemed like it was ever going to happen, really.
T-minus 45 seconds and counting.
None of us had any idea. It wasn't going to come on in Manhattan. The cable system there didn't have it. So the night of the big launch, we were going to have a big party out in Jersey. We had to get on a bus and go to Jersey.
T-minus 20 seconds and counting.
And we're downstairs in this basement. It was perfect for MTV because we wanted to be like that sort of rebel group. And we were, man. They stuck us down in the basement. There's a million people and some, you know, cheesy hors d'oeuvres.
Technical glitches caused the initial segments to air out of order. But all the VJs would treasure their memories of that first night.
This is launch control at T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, six.
We were, the five of us certainly were just incredibly excited. We were just nervous.
Five, four, we've gone for main engine start.
At 12 o'clock, all of a sudden, doot, doot, just a rocket blast off, and I swear everybody was just like,
We have main engine start.
Ladies and gentlemen, rock and roll.
I remember how I felt. I mean, when I actually sort of teared up when the rocket took off.
Everybody was just holding each other and crying and just, here it was, because so many people had worked for so long for this unknown thing. It was finally, this baby was being born.
I heard you on the wireless back in 52.
Video killed a radio star. The first part of the song still gives me tingles. You know, it just drives me crazy.
Video killed the radio star. Video killed the radio star.
Pictures came and broke your heart.
That was a great night because, you know, we had worked very hard. When I say we, I don't mean just the DJs. The entire crew.
I'm Alan Hunter.
I'm Martha Quinn.
Well, all right, I'm J.J. Jackson, and I'll be sitting in with the latest video music performances the way they were meant to be.
Hi, I'm Nina Blackwood.
I'm Mark Goodman, and I'll be here this time every weeknight with the latest concert information and music news. Now, starting right now, you'll never look at music the same way again.
It seemed sort of like we were all in college, and it was, hey kids, let's put on a show.
Begins with a cold and a most peculiar nose, we're told. When his mother tried to soothe his nose, the closer she got, the brighter it glowed. So she wished for new tissues, one of a kind. Then appeared Puffs Plus, a miraculous find. Enchanted pillows kissed with lotion, such a soothing magical potion. And as Rudy felt better, his nose was pleased. The moral? A nose in need deserves Puffs indeed.
This Christmas, only one movie will get your adrenaline pumping, your heart racing, and keep you...
Who the hell was that?
Tranquilia. He's real. On the edge of your seat.
This isn't real.
Wes Craven presents... Dracula 2000, rated R, in theaters everywhere Friday. It's a jungle in there. Donkey Kong Country, rated E on Game Boy Color.
Get into it.
For people who are extremely demanding, the new Schick Extreme 3. Triple blade performance, pivoting action, a perfect grip. And best of all, after a whole bunch of great shaves, you just serve up another one, which is extremely convenient. The new Schick Extreme 3.
It's fun talking to the girls about what makes a guy a great kisser. And if he wasn't, would you go any further? But until you get your sticky, stinky self to the shower, you're not going to attract anything but bugs. A little caress and you feel sweet. You feel sexy. You feel nothing. what? You're resourceful? Happy hour's about to begin. And while your girlfriends look great in leopard and python, you make a stunning entrance in fish. With silky, fragrant Caress body wash, you're so ready for anything.
Disturbed. The Sickness. Featuring Stupefy. And the new single, Voices. Get Disturbed. In stores everywhere.
Wake up to clearer skin with Neutrogena On-The-Spot Acne Patch. While you sleep, it keeps a maximum-strength acne-fighting ingredient and skin soothers where you need it most. To visibly reduce your pimple overnight, Neutrogena On-The-Spot Acne Patch.
What you're watching here is the future of rock and roll.
After day one, it was just like Feed the Beast, you know? It was just like MTV just consumed everything that you did.
Nobody knew what should be happening.
This is garbage.
What are you kidding?
I'm not kidding, really.
Come on! Don't do it, man! Show us your nipple!
We're all just finding our own way so much.
All day, all night, in stereo. They used to call me Video Vamp and Video Vixen.
This thing that's on my hair is not letting go of my hair.
I actually had a guy not too long ago. He says, oh, Nina Blackwood, man. He goes, I had my first sexual experience. He goes, well, I was watching you. And he goes, and I was alone. I'm going, oh, no.
This is MTV television, music television. Where rock and roll, where we rock, can we start over again, son?
The first 6 months was hell for me. Couldn't quite get into the swing of being myself on camera. Nina Blackwood took me over to a restaurant right next door to our studio. I could tell all of a sudden that she was trying to tell me something, you know. They're gonna fire you, Al, if you don't get better quick.
MTV Music Television, we are a first, and we are class.
Run away! Run away, camera! Run away! Run away! Run away! Run away! Run away! Run away!
We were one bored bunch. Here comes my acting skills. Here they go. It was kind of overnight. Not that it was good. I think I sucked for 6 years. But sucked seemed to work.
It seemed like we were all just kind of doing this for our own fun.
We didn't have it in Manhattan for the first year.
It wasn't until we started going out and about to other towns that it was like, oh, wow, people really see what we do.
Then when we hit New York City, it was so great because, I mean, literally, we were like the toast of the town.
We're walking up the street, and we look down, and there's this homeless person. And he goes, Martha Quinn. And the funny thing was, Martha goes, and she was really sweet to him. Hi, how are you? Oh, it's nice of you. Yeah, it's me. Oh, and then we walked up, and she goes, he doesn't have cable.
Coming up in the next hour, Blotto, Graham Parker, Rod Stewart.
And the bars and the cafes.
The horrible fact about the beginning of MTV was that they didn't have a whole lot of catalog there.
A lot of Rod Stewart and Pat Benatar. Thank heaven somebody had done some videos.
I think the hesitation in making videos was that this video realm was going to certainly kill music.
They were playing a lot of like obscure stuff that was coming out of England and different things like that.
There was Duran Duran, Girls on Film. And that was a big one for us.
I loved the Human League. I loved Kaja Goo Goo. And we certainly could claim, you know, credit for exposing them to America.
All of a sudden then kids were going to record stores saying, we want these records. And the record stores said, where are you seeing this? On MTV? So they started stocking it and business got better. And from a commercial standpoint, what the heck, that's not so bad.
I want my MTV. All right.
Welcome back to MTV. It's good to have you here. Good to see you.
Yeah, right. It's great.
The major interviews went to my brethren there, Mark and JJ, who are probably a little bit more musically knowledgeable about things. So when it came to Paul McCartney and that kind of stuff, of course, they were down beating the doors down.
You know, occasionally you run into, like, Mark would want to do Springsteen and I'd want to do Springsteen. So, you know, like, you know, you're jockeying for position, but it was no big deal.
Let's talk about your stage show a little bit then.
It's kind of like a horror show, but on the stage with things like midgets with humps and things.
Ozzy was probably the most difficultly weird interview I've ever done.
And you think, well, I know this guy, but where do I know this guy from? And my manager goes, oh, hello.
I'm looking at the producer. He's not even answering the right question. He's somewhere else.
David Lee Roth, who I loved Van Halen, couldn't wait to interview him, but I knew I was prepped, you know. I knew, man, Dave's going to come in here. He's going to be a partier. He's not going to answer any of my questions. There's no one more charming on the earth than David Lee Roth. And you see me, and I'm sitting like this.
That doesn't mean smile and fun and boogie boogie all the time. It's very possible to have a great time without smiling once.
He must have just thought, what, who did they stick me with? I'm not the others, I do anything. I'm not
the same. I have no shame. I'm on fire. I knew that Madonna was great. I was probably one of the few who really loved her first record, and the first video, Burn It Up, I just thought was really cool. I was really excited to meet her and to interview her.
Boy Toy mean to you?
What does it mean? What do you think it means?
Oh, you're good at that. Just turning those questions right around.
Years later, I went on a tour with her for a little while and said, so, I remember, I'm Mark Goodman. I met you before you were Madonna. And she goes, I was always Madonna. Okay.
Happy New Year. We're going to be doing it all tonight. And everything will be live all night long.
That first New Year's Eve show was, boy, was that something. I don't think I've ever been more frightened in my life.
This is working like a charm, isn't it? Everybody's sitting around me grinning.
The only thought in my head was, oh, please, Christ, don't let me have a heart attack while I'm standing here.
I am Alan Hunter coming to you live from Radio City Music Hall. Yes! On the first annual MTV Video Music Awards. I want a new drum. Live events were my favorites. We very rarely were on camera together because we had that shift-oriented thing, so those kind of events were really cool.
There is no question about it. This is history in the making.
I really felt like a part of it that day. You know? Together, we all made history. You did feel like part of the world community. You really felt like you were making a difference.
If you need any passes to the Cheap Trick concert, we got them. No problem. I was probably known as the VJ who liked most to be out of the studio.
How about it, huh?
I liked being around people. I liked kind of doing the man in the street thing.
Can you flex and talk at the same time?
Yeah, a nudist Christian church?
Yes, sir.
Why aren't you nude now?
Tell you what, I haven't looked yet, but are those fig leaves?
No.
Thank you for talking with us.
I was always really in awe and grateful for what was happening, and I actually loved the work.
I thought this was the greatest job. I thought that I would be at MTV for my whole life.
Some may come, some may do it better, but none can say they had my name.
Magic the Gathering's research facility. Experts test combat strategies using subjects selected from the general public.
Geez! Where do you get these kids?
Play my card, you moron!
I'm unblockable!
What are you waiting for? An invitation?
Magic the Gathering, the trading card game.
You ready to feel the pain?
Thank you.
pumping, your heart racing, and keep you...
Who the hell was that?
Tranquilia, he's real. On the edge of your seat.
This isn't real.
Wes Craven presents Dracula 2000, rated R, in theaters everywhere Friday.
Cleaning supplies, $48 on debit MasterCard. Express package to godmother, $14 on debit card. Shoe repair, $9 on debit card. Finishing chores in time to meet Prince Charming, priceless. Debit MasterCard's faster than writing checks. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's debit MasterCard.
Introducing Nokia Mobile Messaging. Nokia, connecting people. Presenting Trident Advantage. It's a different kind of gum from Trident. It actually replenishes calcium to help prevent cavities and strengthen teeth. For stronger teeth, Trident Advantage Gum.
When Dave Thomas created Wendy's Spicy Chicken Sandwich, he used a whole breast fillet seasoned with his own blend of pepper and spices, but did he go too far?
Very spicy.
Well, it's perfect.
Depends on who you ask. Try Wendy's Spicy Chicken Sandwich.
You have questions.
Fox News Channel, the most powerful name in news. Neil Cavuto, Griff Hume, Shepard Smith. Powerful coverage. Wall Street, Washington, the world. Bill O'Reilly, Hannity and Combs, Paula Zahn. Powerful insights, confronting the politics, the newsmakers, and the issues. Fair and balanced. Fox News Channel, the most powerful name in news. We report, you decide.
Can't find the right car for you? Shop VHICS.com. Want access to a half million used cars? VHICS.com. Lease or purchase? VHICS.com. Or do side-by-side comparisons? VHICS.com. Need to find the right local dealer? VHICS.com. Find the right car for you. VHICS.com. Roadmap to the automotive world.
This is my wife.
Pleased to meet you.
And this is little Dougie Jr.
Dougie Jr.
You're the boss. You must have a big TV.
Well, I have a few.
Do you have a satellite dish or AT&T digital cable?
I have a dish.
Then you can't get local channels unless you pay more.
I can't.
No, and you bought all expensive equipment when you could use the cable you already had.
I did?
Yeah. How'd you get to be boss?
AT&T digital cable. It's smarter.
I would see Mark and JJ making tapes of stuff, and I'd be like, ha, ha, I don't need to make tapes. I'm going to be here forever. I don't need to have any kind of resume reel. I'm Martha Quinn, and I've got music news.
Our original duties as VJs were gradually starting to be taken away. Kurt came in, and it's not Kurt's fault, but they were dividing it up a little bit to the news department and then what we were doing on the air.
Nina and JJ went around the same time.
And that was... In 86, I could feel it kind of coming.
It's 5 years we've all been together, and Nina couldn't be here. She said she was sending me a lovely note saying why she couldn't be here, but it might be the last time you'll see the four of us together anyway for some time.
I stayed in my my dressing room because it was just so emotionally overwhelmed. I mean, these were my family, you know, this really was my family.
It's been a wonderful being associated with MTV from the very beginning and with all of these wonderful people.
It really felt like the family was busting up, and Nina had this other life going on.
That year, I got a couple of offers. Solid Gold wanted me over there.
Here's Nina Blackwood.
And they wanted me to do interviews.
Pressures of success took its toll on your personal life.
Mm-hmm. You get caught up in a world that sometimes is unrealistic.
So it was just the timing.
We're all amazed that we were there that long. And I think that the longevity of our careers there was due in part to us being the originals.
I'm the grandfather.
This whole video revolution.
And we stayed on like the original cast of any show does. You know, you need to have the show flesh itself out. And then you get rid of everybody and put new ones in.
Wubba, wubba, wubba.
I got along well with Julie when she first came. The combination of them leaving and somebody new coming in was sort of strange.
Martha and Mark and I definitely looked at each other and said, wow, you know, how long do we want to be VJs?
Basically, my contract was up and my phone stopped ringing and they stopped sending cabs to my front door. So I moved to Los Angeles and was on the Brady series.
You're asking me what I think you're asking me. The answer is yes, Bobby Brady.
Kind of shift for the industry as a whole was out to Los Angeles. So I had a year-old son. Dylan was a year old at that time, and I felt like going to Los Angeles and kind of pursuing whatever talent career I would have out there would be a little easier to raise a family.
I know for Alan and I, we quit on the same day. It was really kind of heart-wrenching. It was the end. It was really the end of an era.
They came back and offered me another job. It was a live show called Rockline on MTV, and people could call in and ask the artist questions.
Have you ever tried to parody a song and the original artist wouldn't let you do it?
It happens very infrequently. Most artists have a good sense of humor and they realize it's not a put-down.
I was like, wow, this is great. I've been given a second chance to really, really enjoy this, and I did.
Thank you very much for your call.
And I'm so grateful to MTV for giving me that, as well as giving me a name and an identity and someone who can go out and go do, you know, Neutrogena commercials.
Breakouts. What does a girl have to do to get clear skin?
And people go, oh, Martha Quinn, I mean, that's fantastic.
Yes!
And I've been
a mom for the past year, so I've taken some time off to do that.
No matter what happens, I've always got the fellow VJs. That's the thing I feel proudest of about my years at MTV, is this family that MTV gave me with the five, you know, Alan, Mark, JJ, and Nina, that we're all still in contact. We have a real devotion to one another.
And it's odd because all five of us really lived, lived a completely different lifestyle. For kind of a novice like me, this is not a bad group. Yet when any adversity came upon us, we all would pull together. I really truly can say I love them all. It's the Storyteller's edition of the Beatle Years. I still love music. Love Me Do, the first single released by the Beatles on October 5th, 1962.
Music has always been what I'm about. I work in radio here in LA, and I've worked at like the pioneering rock station here, K-Rock, and I love it.
I get a call just like my cohorts do for things that are musically oriented. I've done several infomercials. It's called the Rolling Stone Collection, and there's never been anything like it. So I'm back in Birmingham, kind of, I wanted to get out of the rat race of Hollywood. I moved back to my hometown 4 or 5 years ago because I wanted to have my own business. We've called it Hunter Films, and our slogan is, we make films, not money. How about them costumes, boy? Man, that's low budget stuff.
This is Nina Blackwood.
I do a lot of voiceovers these days. Commercials, any kind of thing, radio spot, TV spot.
My past is yours, as is my future.
I absolutely love animals. I've been involved with a wildlife way station. Then I've also been involved with the Humane Society. All right, you're never gonna go there, never.
MTV definitely changed the way people heard music and looked at television. It definitely had an impact. So I'm very proud to have been part of that.
Thank you, everybody.
We're, you know, a little part of the history books. As Mark Goodman says, we'll always be the answer to a trivia question.
In retrospect, I've come to respect what we did a lot. It's a lot harder than I imagined. We were one of the most important things going on in music, and I couldn't have predicted it, but wow, I lucked out and I was a part of it.